We got Vic Mensa in the building. Vic, what's going on, my dude?
Yo, what up?
You are at Peter Palooza tonight, but we'll get to Peter Palooza. It's sold out. You can't even see Vic Mensa tonight at that.
We might release like a few more tickets, but yeah, it is sold out. Fact.
But if you want to see Vic Mensa, let's big up the Matt
Yeah,
Eason
if
joint.
You want to see Vic Mensa. Who does an incredible live show, by the way. The Traffic Tour, August 8th, Mad Decent in Brooklyn. Then he has DC, Boston, Toronto, Detroit, Seattle, and Portland. But that Brooklyn show, Mad Decent, is going to be incredible.
We're going to get on his record, two of your records while you're here. We're going to get on the Justine Sky. She's from Brooklyn, so we got to show her love.
Yeah, that's my girl.
And we're going to play the Kanye West. Obviously, that's Chicago love. Speaking of Chicago, Spike Lee's working on Chi-Raq in Chicago. Are you into that or reserving comment until you see it?
I'm reserving comment at this moment. You know, best of luck to them doing what they do. We'll see.
We'll see. So that's a we'll see.
It's a wait and see situation.
Gotta be.
All right.
I mean, you know, it's just a very serious subject, and it's gotta be handled right by someone that really cares.
And is sensitive to how serious it is.
It's not even that I'm stressing sensitivity in art. It's just like, it's just accuracy. It's like you're talking about somewhere so real that's, you know, homicide levels over the Middle East. It's like you gotta be approaching that like it is what it is.
So you're saying once people
can't romanticize that, you can't just decide what that looks like. You know what I'm saying? That looks like something that's very clear.
I heard Common turned down a role. I saw Lala just got casted for
when you see the word Chi-Raq. Is that what perks your ear up to, like, oh, I hope this isn't just trying to capitalize on what the...
I mean, that's the immediate thought. You see Chi-Raq, that's just like, that's so sensational that it's like, if you're going to do that, you're going to take it that angle, you have to represent, like, these people that we got tatted on us that died to Chi-Raq. You know, you have to do them justice and honor. You can't
just make
your own idea of what that is.
Well, you're passionate about social issues. That's a part of who you are. That's a part of your DNA as a black man.
I think it should be a part of who all of us are.
It should.
It should be, yeah.
But you also want the accuracy of how the socioeconomic situation in Chicago has played a role into this behavior, I'm sure, as well, right?
Definitely.
And speaking of that, the Sandra Bland story, we're all watching this video roll out. And over the last week, of this woman who they're saying committed suicide, and I don't think anybody really believes that. She was pulled over in a routine traffic stop, and then yesterday, they want to roll out that she had weed in her system.
Mm. They killed her. She was killed by authorities in jail. I think it's really important that anybody listening understands that and goes and looks at the facts and isn't skewed and isn't weighed by, you know, their own, like, misunderstanding of how this country really works. She was killed in jail. That's what happened, and it needs to be exposed.
Very interesting. If you haven't seen the Sandra Bland video, Google that. Go to dailynews.com, NY Daily News, somewhere, and look at it. Because the video.
Go listen to the voicemails that she left. She only made 2 phone calls her first day. She's supposed to get out, go to a new job on Wednesday. Supposed to get out Monday. Only made 2 phone calls her first day. Supposedly killed herself 3 days later.
And the
doesn't make sense. You listen to her voicemails to her friends. She was not suicidal. You know.
And you saw that Ava DuVernay agreed that the video that was released, it was edited. She was like, "This is what I do for
me." She could see the edits in it. And Sandra Bland was originally from the Chicago area and had moved to Texas. Is that right?
I think she might have been from Naperville or something. She was from a suburb of Chicago.
Yeah, and she had just moved back down to her alma mater where she had gone to school for a job.
She had a job going on down there.
Top 9-7, 97 minutes, commercial free. Chicago's own Vic Mensa's here.
Everything be crazy.
So one got to go on the way. The extra special Rosenberg birthday wrestling one got to go. Do you want to throw out who's in your one
got
to go ensemble list today so people could start getting to these phones?
Sure.
Vic Mensa could think about where he's at with one got to go. Are you, Vic, are you understanding what one got to go is?
Looks like we got 3 people. And,
4.
Or 4 people.
And one
got to
go.
And one we just not rocking with, it doesn't matter.
Never existed. Okay. No.
If you had to get rid of one, which one?
Uh-huh. You know what it basically is? It's basically F, Mary, Kill, but it's like F, right, F, right, right. F, Kill. That's basically what
right,
the
game is. What's your list?
All right, guys. Wrestling. History. WWE. One's got to go. Okay?
All right.
Hulk Hogan.
No.
My guy. Macho Man Randy Savage.
Mm-mm.
Laura.
Sorry.
Stone Cold Steve Austin. and The Rock, a.k.a. the star of Ballers, The Rock.
The Rock is going nowhere. Nowhere.
I don't know. Some people will go the opposite, Laura. Some people. My gut reaction is that I love him to death.
But wrestling fan.
I'm getting rid of The Rock.
I think The Rock has to go.
How did you get rid of The Rock? No.
So anyways, if you want to get on the phone, it's 800-223-9797. That's what we're going to do for my birthday. I appreciate this, Ebro. This is a big deal. This is a big...
That's
all I
got to
do for Rosenberg is talk about wrestling.
And you gave me an oily massage.
Oh, what? God.
Well, he didn't do it.
That's the type of birthday it is?
No, he didn't do it. He paid for someone else to do it. A cute woman.
It sounds very strange.
Right, so get on the phone. 800-223-9797. Player one got to go. But in the meantime, I want to talk to Vic Mensa about the pandemonium, speaking of wrestling, that is rap music today. Right now, today.
The Royal Rumble that's happening.
No holds barred match. Meek Mill has come out and it said that if he knew that Drake didn't write the verse on Rico, get Rico ready, man. Drake and Meek, Casto Facto.
Facto.
He would have taken him off the album, which opened up a whole other thing. And then last night, the original reference to 10 bands from Quentin Miller was released. In your experience as an artist coming up in the game, do you write all of your verses and songs? And what portions do you write?
I write all of my music. Yeah. I mean, but I bounce ideas with my friends sometimes. You know, we might come up with some freestyling and that'll become the hook of a song.
Got it.
You know? But yeah, I write all my lyrics. I don't have anybody writing for me. But you know, just in my experience working with other people, I think the situation's kinda petty, first of all. I think that Drake is like enormously talented and not just a rapper, you know, he's a franchise. But I at the same time understand frustration from verses, like whole verses being not written by somebody, you know, that you look up to like that or that you expect a certain standard of quality from. I think it matters. I don't think it at all takes away the fact that Drake is like an amazing rapper though. It doesn't make him less of a good rapper to me. Maybe it demystifies a little bit of like the legend, but
he's still a great
Drake
rapper.
Cold as hell at rapping. Nobody wrote all the like super personal shit about his mom being 5'2". Oh, my bad. Crying on his stomach. You know what I'm saying? No, I don't think somebody wrote those bars. Right?
So in your mind, you're like, it's not that we already know he can. Just on particular moments, he didn't.
And it's not just about, you know, that you can. It's like, you got to come with it, for sure. It is rap. I feel like the situation petty, though. But then again, it's like, man, whatever. It's cool. Like, let it be a little bit of somebody trying to talk, you know?
It's fun. You mean just talking about something.
Nobody wants to say anything. You know, everybody's too scared to say anything, like, negative or just, you know, a little bit to the left. So I think it's cool. It's fun.
When it comes to rap, you don't have a problem writing for anybody else?
No. I don't have a problem writing for anybody else.
And how common do you think it is a thing, though, to have people write hooks or pieces and how
reference tracks?
Very common. It's super common. I mean, most of the successful artists in the game are major label artists. Major labels, a lot of them are like, you know, factories. They're just like, I need beat songs for this person, you know?
Ideas for this one, ideas for that one.
Yeah.
Sometimes they get a complete song, sometimes they just get pieces.
I think if this was a case of Drake not being a songwriter, you know what I'm saying, that would be a bigger issue. I think it's established that Drake is a songwriter because he's written so many hits for himself and for others, you know? It's not the question of whether or not he's a pop star or a rapper, you know, because he is undoubtedly still a rapper.
I like it.
Well said.
Well said. Now, there are purists in hip-hop who are mad. Purists with this rap thing who haven't liked Drake from the beginning.
Talk about it.
Who are irritated by Drake's success and recent lack of support. Like Meek said, he didn't support tweeting his album, which I think was part of the irritation, right? And now Drake is obviously building his OVO franchise even more. And I don't think it's doing as many collabos and appearing at people's concerts. And maybe that might be the basis of some of this irritation. We don't know.
But like we said, maybe Drake didn't want to promote the album yet because he didn't have his points worked out on the album yet. It is a business. And Rico is the biggest song right now that people are playing.
That song probably ain't come out without the splits being...
That's not necessarily true, though. I know big label situations where the splits are not completely done, but the album's got to move. So you're like, cool, let's get it done. We'll figure it out. But if it doesn't get figured out,
well, now we're getting a little inside in the business. Sorry, people may be interested in it, but Vic, I appreciate you having comment.
But Meek a cold rapper too.
Yes,
very cold.
Meek been going crazy since he had fuzzy braids.
And that's why. But that's also why Meek is super sensitive about if you're not writing, because he takes pride in his abilities.
And he should.
And wants to make sure that the audience knows that, listen, there are cats that really get it in, and then there are cats who are great songwriters.
There's not a lot of people that really get it in with Drake on the rapping tip, though. Like, from raps that you know he wrote. Or, I mean, you hope you know he wrote. You know?
That's the hard part, right?
There's not a lot of people that really get it in with him, and I don't even think everybody in this conversation getting it in with him like that.
Mm-hmm. Have you lost your mind, B? We're playing One Gotta Go, bro.
Hey, yo, if you don't get this redneck butt ice... Drinking. He's a redneck, bro. He
got to
go. Other people are legends, man.
Wait. You
talking about Stone Cold, B.
My G, you can't just be calling him just a redneck. Yeah, he's a redneck, but you can't just call. He's amazing.
He's bad. First of all, you're comparing him to Hulk Hogan, Macho Man. Those are legends. I'm a WWF fanatic. I'm surprised you ain't got Razor Ramon, my man up there. Everybody else is... He's a bum compared to the other...
Yo, you,
yo, my man.
Yo, my man, you wearing a Nietzsche jeans right now?
He's loose.
You wearing a Nietzsche, aren't you? He's one of those dudes outside right now talking about Drake, too. Man, Drake ain't your MC! Yeah. And F Stone Cold Steve Austin!
You not taking nothing in?
No, listen, I don't know if I should even take this call, because what you're saying, gotta go, is a violation of epic proportions. What
is it? How is it a violation of epic proportions?
You Macho Man is not even on the table.
Whoa. What are you saying right now?
He's not even alive, so he gotta go.
Right. Okay, you gonna throw out the only dead guy? Yo, the disrespect.
You can't. He had Elizabeth. She was the baddest manager ever in WWE history.
And Macho Man is the only Jew on the list, so I'm gonna take this as disrespect.
That's why you wanna keep him, because he's a Jew.
Yo, violation again. Another Macho Man, Sonny in New Jersey.
Yeah, I gotta say Macho Man. Sorry,
no, based on what?
I mean, out of all four, I'm a fan of all four, but if you're gonna compare, I mean, Hogan and The Rock are pretty much on the same boat.
No, they're not. First of all, they're not.
They both turned into movie stars. I'm talking about,
But we're not talking about their movies. And by the way, Hogan turned into a movie star? Jeez. He never made a good movie. Stop it right now.
Wait. You're saying The Rock has?
The Rock has made good movies.
Oh, yeah, he was in, was it Fast and Furious was good?
Yeah, he's been in a bunch of good movies that I like. I liked his first couple of movies.
All right, fair enough.
He's at least a legitimate movie star. Hulkster, but y'all, what are you really saying? Like, I love The Rock, but you got to be realistic about what does The Rock do better than Macho
talk,
Man.
Yo, you're more passionate about wrestling talk than you are Meek and Drake.
Well, this is more real.
Wrestling's more real? Yo, Chris.
Yeah.
One gotta go.
I'm going to say The Rock's
gotta
go.
I'm going to say this right now. Anybody that say The Rock gotta go, including Vic Mensa, you just hating because he'll take your bitch any night. That's what it is. That's the only reason.
I mean, listen, you're talking about Ebro's man crush.
Yeah, I mean,
Don't disrespect his man crush. I forgot.
Ebro, relax, man. I know that's your bro.
I follow him on IG.
I know you like his pictures.
I'm double tapping photos all day.
Yo, that sounds so crazy.
Pause too far?
I know what, Ebro.
Vic, what'd you say?
I said, you gonna let The Rock hit.
if you're
standing there and he wants your girl, what you gonna do?
Yo, Rock, you could get that money.